Right, I think, you know, as you get older, you really do start to appreciate, and, you know, as a young guy, you just don't realize how hard and how long the road is, and, you know, really what it took. You just kind of come to the rink and do what you're told and, you know, play hard. And sure, I mean, I watch everybody grow. You know, I wasn't just worried about myself and my one part. It was be able to take a step back and see some of these guys improve as players and people, these young guys that we've bled with and sweat with and did everything with on and off the ice. It's been a fantastic year, and what a way to end it, I'll tell you what.
Now to look out the Aeros with a puck in the draw and a good chance point blank. Mrazek, a good stop. Here's Scandell in the slot, a drive, score! Breakaway Fontaine, he's in. Backhander score, 2-0 Aeros. He lost the puck in the draw right between the legs of Mrazek. A horrible break for the Griffins there. And the puck's on the near side. Good hit there by Perry. Step hard into McMillan. 4-on-2 the other way. Here's Billings to Shane. Drop pass to Tatar. In shot, score! Tomas Tatar! And the Griffins break the scoring drought here. They get their first playoff goal. Angles into the middle, drop the puck to Peach. He walks in with a shot, save, rebound. Hogan a chance and a right pad save by Kemper. Yurko a wrapper on attempt, and that one deflected away. Played by Peach. He lets it go, score! Deflected in, I think, by Yurko. Now Glenn Denning in the corner behind from Ursak. Good pass, Yurko. Great move in front and lost it at the last moment. Now picks it up, rolled it to the goal. Stop. Another wraparound, score! Tomas Yurko! And that will just about put it away. And the Griffins will get done what they were hoping to get done. And that was at least a split.
Looks simple enough there. Just the push off, and he just lifting it. Looks like it's his glove side leg, his left leg. You could tell he's
looks like beginning right.
So it gets worse. So we've got Heatley.
Come on, Heels.
Now we have Backstrom, and we got to rely on a guy.
We're showing you this nationally.
It's going to be a best of one.
Oh, well, he's already limping. So.
Harding's got one win all year, and he's got to win four in the next 2 weeks against the best team.
Well, the other thing that might happen is, and this is purely speculation, is they got the other guy Kemper, and I wouldn't be surprised. Maybe he come. Obviously, he'll be up, and maybe he becomes the starter in game two if Harding doesn't deliver.
Kemper's played very well in Houston for them.
If this guy isn't in the corner at all, you see that, we can go ahead and flush this guy out, and then F2's just going to meet him, make sure F2 doesn't get beat up the ice at that point. Our set breakout will stay with the double stretch. The changes here don't really matter. Obviously a new goalie, but the same concept, it doesn't matter. What I called around on him, it was no glaring weaknesses, okay? So it's the same stuff, no matter whether we're facing him or Kemper, we've got to be on him for sure. We've got to be on the crease, we've got to have great depth of screen, and you know you're going to have to fight hard to get to the net because they want to make sure you can't get there. And again, we take hits to make plays, we give hits, and we're setting the tone on that right away. Start for us in net, Peter Mrazek. Yeah. Evans and Billings on D. Grant Aubrey Polkin.
Go! Break it, break deep, break deep. Good job, boy.
Played by Jeff Hogan, now here's Chad Ryle. Shot knocked away and the rebound, they score.
Nick Bagwell.
Matter being committed, a little more committed than they are in all little areas, making sure we're doing all the things right. We got more here. We got more in our game. Let's make sure we take it over here. Let's go.
This guy has seen against Euros.
Oh, man. Living in your dad's shadow, eh?
circle. Fakes in front. Score! Adam Alquist. Griffins lead 3-2 with 3:38 to go. Griffins will come back home and take game three. This one is over. 4-2 the final. Alquist, the game winner. And the Griffins, in a best-of-five series, will have a chance here Friday to take the Houston Aeros out and advance to the next round.
Who's got the puck there?
I get us pretty much every day in here. Bob's grand, you guys' line is great, but Timu, a nice finish.
Great pass!
No speech. That's a speech right there.
Did he help you with the note with a nice finish? Did he help you with that? Okay. Series still isn't over, right? So we got to make sure that's our mindset here the rest of the way. We got to, you jam the, you keep the gas pedal down and you finish it when you get a chance, right? But we got to be prepared. The number one thing is be prepared for Friday. So yeah, we'll go 11 and we'll go from there. Any questions? Good job. Yeah.
Defensively, Minnesota plays that system. They follow suit. They're pairing to their AHL affiliate. And yet you managed to get 109 shots on them in three games.
Yeah, but not as, you know, but that's part of the way we want to play. We want to be in their end as much as possible. We want to be in our end as little as possible. And I think when you're in their end watch, you're going to get shots. And we've done a good job of shooting the puck and then getting back on top of it and getting pucks back. And that's a big key. You know, so we're going to have to continue to do the same. Part of the reason we have so many shots is because it's been real hard to get to seconds. And so we've been forced to really go back and retrieve and get it back again. And, you know, I think they're okay with that too. I don't think their game plan is to get as many shots as we have. So at the end of the night, we got to have more goals than them. Hopefully we can execute similar to we did on Wednesday. Just make sure we keep tracking off those opportunities. We know it's going to be a 60-minute game. Let's get prepared here for a good second period. Let's go get that one. Let's not give them anything easy, hard plays out of our end here. Let's go.
Here's Fontaine with a puck to McIntyre. He's going to score into the empty net. We're going to a fifth and decisive game tomorrow night.
Yeah, I mean, it's nice to be at home for sure, so we're going to have that going for us. And, momentum's going to be key. You know, little things, little mental mistakes, and then flip-flops the other way. But we got to play complete 60. If you're going to bury a team, finish them off, you got to be complete. So that's the case for tomorrow. Yeah, just being resilient, I guess, you know, like especially mentally. Obviously, the physical demand of playoffs just felt right away, you know, after that first game coming out hard, and guys, you know, it's a lot more physical. So, but yeah, being resilient mentally, because sometimes the puck doesn't bounce your way, or the, you know, you go down in a series and you can't quit, right? It's whatever the series was. The first one was 5, and it's the first one to get to 3 games out of the 5, and you know, we got down game one and just came back and fought our way back, and being resilient was kind of key.
Well, not that they're not getting chances, but nice to see your 1-2 goal scorers to Tarn and Ferraro bust loose here tonight.
Yeah, you know, no question. And
but we can't rely, you know, the one thing about that is we haven't relied on one or two guys all year. We've been a team that's scored with good depth, and so we're going to have to do that again. And, you know, Tatar's facing a tough line every single time he's out there. They do a real good job of getting the match they want, even though they're on the road, because they change on the fly, and they get the guys out there they want. So he's playing against some real hard players. And you know, and Lando's been going hard, and he's had great looks, you know. So you hope you get scared if you're not getting chances. They're getting chances. I think they'll be just fine.
Make sure, like, you play for opportunities to play in these types of games, for sure. These are the fun ones, for sure, so make sure you enjoy it. You focus on the process here, but you enjoy it, okay? These are the ones, this is why you're competitive, this is why you play sports for a living, and make sure you enjoy it, okay? All right, start for us. Peter Mrazek. Mason Holmquist. Tarshi and Perry.
Get it back to the line. Billings will take a look at a shot. Deflected in front. Rebound attempt. Score! Frankie Perry! Frank the Stolas tie. Side quick shot. Score! Kulov's to third. Sure enough, both referees look at it, discuss it, and it is a goal. Callahan, he's got Mrazek streaking a backhand shot. Score! Jan Mrazek! 4-0 Griffins lead that punches triple between the pads.
And the Nuggetings are game. It's strong, it's hard, it's grinding them down low. We go low to high, you got a shot, take the shot, no shot, rim it to the bottom. Grind them. No easy penalties, so keep the sticks down, all that kind of. Let's keep the gas down and the focus high here. Let's go, Nuggetings.
Now we're going to have a fight. Stephen Kamper and Tomas Tatar dropped the glove. They were having words back in the second period, and Kamper is going to challenge Tatar. He's a tough little guy, Tomas Tatar. We'll see how Kamper is as the two of them come through on the right, and Kamper's down. The walk right in with a shot. Score! Adam on Christmas. And the old Tomas score! He will poke it out. They went to the limit, 5 games, but to win that 5th game in convincing fashion, 7-0, Peter Mrazek with the 24-save shutout.
But you know what, like, good teams find a way, and obviously, 5 games, we could have been done after that, but, like, you know what, the Pesky Griff, they kept coming. And 7-0, I think we left no doubt behind us, and we moved on after that.
Everybody played really good tonight, like the score 7-0, Peter, Frankie, but 2 goals, 1 apple, a fight, that's...
Kante!
First of all, boys, sorry for the fight, and second, we just show how good we are when we compete, and I think game 5, and we prove how good we are, and so I can't wait for the next round, and let's win it.
Yeah!
That's a speech, man. That's good. I told him not to fight. Okay, so great job. Great. job. We stayed with it. It was frustrating. We stayed with it, and that's what happens in the end when you do that.
Great job, boys. Great job.